Hello, this is Jose Luis here at Parametric Camp, and welcome to another video in this series, Introduction to Beegraphy. I think that's what we're going to call it. And in this video, I would like to take our first look at the online parametric modeling editor that Beegraphy allows us. All right, it's a very cool project, so let me show you how it works. So I'm already logged in, I created an account on Beegraphy, and you can see that as you land on the website, there's these two main options that are given to you, the editor and the market. I'm definitely going to take a look at the market later because I really like the feature, but we're going to start by the beginning, which is the editor. If you click on the editor, then you're basically going to land into this dashboard of whatever models you have made previously. If you're new to the platform, you have no models whatsoever, right? And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to create a new model, and I'm going to call this like intro to the editor, for example. All right. And the moment I click on that, then I am thrown right away into the online parametric modeler that the folks at Beegraphy have been developing. All right. So the way I'm going to phrase this is going to be by comparison with probably one of the most popular parametric modelers out there right now, as of the recording of this video, which is Grasshopper, okay? So it's basically, what we have here is basically this online canvas where I can drop components, right? Similar to what I would do in Grasshopper, and each component basically representing a function of some kind. A function that takes inputs, it takes data, for example, a couple numbers, and then performs some operation on that data, like multiplying them, dividing them, creating a point out of those numbers, etc., etc. Now, what you will notice, though, is that the main difference with other desktop-based parametric modelers that actually integrate into a real 3D modeler is that here we have both things combined. So what we have is, on one hand, we have this screen viewer, if you will. I'm actually going to move this to the left-hand side so that it's out of my way here. All right. Yeah, you have this online view, which represents the 3D model that we're creating. And then we have this bar with all the components that we can use. So for example, if you click here, you have all the mathematical operators. If you click here, you have a bunch of list components, which basically are useful for manipulating data streams. Tool is where most of the geometry operations are. So you have curves, vectors, surfaces, triangulation, Delaunay, Voronoi, solids, etc., etc. And you have a few other components like exporter. We will see this when we talk about the market. And for example, inputs. So do you have sliders? Do you have a Boolean slider? Do you have a mathematical expression, etc., etc.? All right. And just to show you how simple and intuitive this is, what I would like to do is I would like to model a simple box that is centered on a point. All right. So if I want to model a box, the first thing I would like to look for is for some kind of component that allows me to create boxes, right? I could just go here to tools here, and then probably under solid, there's like box by 2 points, box by center, box. So probably box by center is the one that I'm looking at. And you can already see that the moment I drop this on the canvas, I already get this representation of that box in my 3D viewer. And remember, the 3D viewer, I can make it full screen, I can change the shadings, I can give it some, I can turn off, I can turn off the grid, for example, I can do top view, I can do front view, perspective view. It's actually quite nice, all right? And then, but if I don't know where to find things, or if I don't want to sit down and just look through all the possible options because it's a little overwhelming, something that we can also do is I can just double click on the canvas, and then this drop down search box will show up. So I can now type here box, and then you can see that I have a bunch of options for what can I do with boxes. So for example, I can do box by center, which is the one that I had before. Okay, you can see that right now the box is centered in the origin. It has a width of 5, length, height. So I probably want to customize the dimensions. The way I do that, for example, is with Grasshopper is using a slider. Here, in Beegraphy, sliders are called range inputs. Okay, so if I click on range input, you can see that now I get a slider that I can customize. So for example, this is going to be 10 and this is going to be in increments of 0.1. Okay, and I'm also going to double click here to say box width. You know, I am very OCD about, so I'm going to plug this in here. Okay, and then I am going to now plug this in here. And I'm getting an error. It has to be greater than 5, than 0. Okay. So box, this is going to be the length. And now this is going to be the height. Correct? And you saw that I did that by basically copy pasting, right? So now I have a width control, height control, and length control. Beautiful. And you can also see that here under the origin, in the origin, I have an input of the type point, which means that I can control as well where the center of this box is. So then maybe what I want to do is I want to customize that center by creating a point manually. So let's go to point and construct a point by XYZ coordinates. So right now, that point is centered at 0, 0, 0. But if I do the same thing, and I set a range input, and I copy paste this 3 times, right? And I said it's going to be X, it's going to be Y, it's going to be Z. And now I can control the location of this box, all right? Beautiful. So that's it. Literally, this is just the Beegraphy editor. As you can see, the UI, the family is very familiar. If you have used other visual programming environments, if you have not, I recommend that you take a look at our Introduction to Parametric Modeling playlist. There's going to be a card popping up somewhere on the corner right now. And but it's very easy, it's very intuitive, if it's very familiar, and you will have a very easy time connecting with the way the Beegraphy editor allows you to model 3D, to model things in 3D. All right, beautiful. So with this, I just wanted to make like a simple example. You don't have to change anything. You don't have to save everything. Any kind of changes that you make are already saved in the file, in the cloud, in the dashboard, inside of Beegraphy. So no need to worry about this. And then what I would like to do is now I would like to make a couple hands-on exercises to practice and to perhaps do more sophisticated modeling, here in Beegraphy. Okay, so let's move on to the next video in this playlist where I'm going to teach you how to model a necklace, for example, full of pearls, right, using the Beegraphy editor. All right, let's take a look at how to do that. See you in the next video. Bye.